the position with this service is it took over and used the service and has been doing things in new service since February. So it's just coming to the end of its first year of delivering a different kind of model. So you're comparing things like light and light in terms of appearance and funding. We do meet and talk through the contract regularly with the provider. They're doing some good work, and as the narrative says, that the turmoil and the transitional issues which people have got left, and we're now seeing their performance overall getting some the going on with the trajectory. So we're just keeping a very close eye on that.
We should see that in the next quarter.
We should see that in the next quarter.
Additional spending might be opening a new model of reports that we've got to ask and just like our new provider.
Yes, we did change the new provider to sort of our programs.
Does anybody else come on? Yeah, Angie, what about Mark?
Can I just ask something on page 80 where it's the number of days on the street and 10 days on the side? So it's to say that there was a spike in October due to the availability of care packages. And I can see that there's kind of like a deep dive of individual cases being done. It'd be interesting to know kind of what that kind of deep dive yields, and also if there's any kind of safeguards to prevent such a spike in the future.
Okay. Demand is very, very high in
hospitals.
We are in the top 10 in terms of the country, in terms of delayed transfers of care. But absolutely unfair. The Health Service Journal, a week or so ago, there's a map of the UK, and in there we're all proudly green compared to everywhere else, so we're doing very well. But we have been working closely with other organisations such as ESIP, the emergency care agreement, because the hospital performance is 4-hour targets, because of those works. So there's almost pressure in terms of getting the beds. But I think there's a counter to that as well, which is that we need to do it properly and it needs to be the right sort of quality as well. So I think this work really is about having the right pathways and the right support. We don't always get it right, but it's important to understand what's going on, because every day in hospital you don't need to be there today when you come on the board. So it's balancing all of those things together.
And I would just like to comment on that, so that you've purchased more transitional intermediate care beds, and I would really like to just say quality is absolutely vital in that area. I would say no more than that. There's not quantity, it's quality as well.
That's right. That's what I think that there's certainly been some concerns about those services in relation to quality. The turnover for people is very, very high. So that means that sometimes the quality of the discharge and the quality of the service isn't as good as it should be. So again, there's a lot of focus on that in terms of one pressure is moving people through a system quickly. But we shouldn't be working in such a way that dehumanises them in the system, and the quality of the care that they get is absolutely critical. I think Al wants to do
something. Al, do you want to make a comment?
Yeah, thanks. Because when we do not work around the whole of the system and how we can support the kind of activity that is going into the hospital. And a lot of what we're doing is around that initial prevention. So we have built up new services using the Better Care Fund to have a 7-day offer around people in crisis so that they don't have to end up in the hospital. And I think what we've got a lot of different kind of like services that we're trying to work together so that we can do a mission avoidance, so that we don't get people into hospital, so that they don't go in decompensated, so that they don't end up in long-term care. So it's kind of like what we're doing at the front end of the system to prevent things, and I know we've done some work on those avoidances. But it's also what we're doing at the discharge end, so that we can get people to the right place once they do need to be discharged. And we're working in with the hospital to reduce that length of stay, so that we try to get all those parts of the system lined up. It's extremely challenging, because no matter how much
6.
So you can't have a massive
children early for school on the 2nd of March. And we won't start that until we get into the next municipal year, but we are ready to go with that. The last focus on session was with Wirral Community Trust, and that was reasonably well attended and it was very informative. And on Thursday of this week, some committee members are going to the Wallasey office of the CRI, who are the company who are delivering the drug whole contract. We're also arranging visits to schools next year, in the next municipal year, for members of the Children's Subcommittee, and they're proposed for the summer term. And these visits will enable members to look at the strategies that are being developed in the schools to narrow the attainment gap. And as always, I've got many other suggestions for the work programme, but we've still got quite a big work programme set for next year.
Chair and the officers for the past year. I think it's been a good year and we're going to do a good work.